Hi and welcome back to Blocksy. In today's video, we're going to learn how to create customized archive templates for your blog posts or even CBTs. This feature is really powerful because it lets you customize the experience for your visitors even further without being limited by a set of predefined options. Enough babble, let's get rolling. To get to the new archive template builder, you simply have to go to the content block section of the dashboard. Click the Add New button up top, and then the template picker will appear. Here, we select Custom Template, and then select the type as Archive. Give it a name, and away we go. A new Gutenberg blank canvas appears. We're ready to start working, but first, let's go through the options to note them down. The first thing you need to think of when building an archive template is which parts of the archive should be replaced. The options are only card and full page. We'll discuss that in a bit. Because many people already like the design offered by the default set of options, we've built a tool that will let you customize just the post cards and their content. With this option, you can create very interesting designs, because you'll be controlling just the card contents using the new Gutenberg dynamic blocks. This offers you endless possibilities of design. One call out here that we'd like to make is that if you use this kind of template, there is a reduced set of options present in the customizer, because you're already controlling the contents via the template builder. You'll see though that we've left all the relevant options still in. Also, there's the full page option, and this will let you use any kind of tool that helps you build full archive loops. There are a lot of third-party options, or you can use the built-in Gutenberg query loop block. At the moment, this block is a little bit limited, but we're hearing good news coming from WordPress's developers about this in the future. And here, if you choose to build this kind of template, no more options are present under the Pages section of the customizer. For this one, we give you all the relevant options available right inside the template builder, so no hassle for you navigating through convoluted menus. Now, before we continue, we'd also like to note the differences in the options available for these two choices. The Cards template will offer you the Dynamic Content Preview option. It lets you dynamically preview the contents of a post to see exactly how your edit will turn out with real content. No switching tabs, no refreshing, and no losing time. The Editor Width setting will let you get a better picture of what you're building. By default, the width of the editor is narrow because the archive cards are smaller than a page. This helps you have a feel of your work in progress layout much easier than having a full-blown Gutenberg page. Sure, we still give you the option to control this with the Editor Width option from the sidebar. We get to the default card layout option next. This setting lets you specify if the archive cards will inherit the styling from the customizer. Things such as background colors, spacing of elements, and shadows can be inherited. Leave this set to default to have a consistent experience. Switching to the full page replacement, we get the usual assortment of page structure options. You can select to have a sidebar, a box layout, and more from here. Pretty simple to understand if you're already accustomed to Blocksy's layout options. Right, so we're done with the options. To continue, we have prepared a little reusable block to speed up the designing process. This reusable block contains dynamic Gutenberg blocks that have been pre-configured. Of course, you can still insert static blocks and customize further and have everything in one place instead of using more content blocks. And this is a wrap. Let's check out what we have achieved on the front end. Looking good as always. Great. We hope this video has been helpful in understanding how the new Archive Template Builder works. It currently supports the Gutenberg dynamic blocks, with more support to come in the future. And as usual, if you have any questions, a suggestion, or you simply want to share something, feel free to drop by creativethemes.com. We'll be more than happy to guide you through. Until next time, take care.